This is what we all been waiting for. Fighting for the International Boxing Association Super Welterweight World Champion title. In the blue corner, 29-year-old from Argentina, weighing at 76.2 kilograms. Please put your hands together for Mateo Veron.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the main event. Mateo Damian Veron versus Lolenga Mock for the vacant IBA Super Middleweight Championship of the world here in Aarhus, Denmark. If you're just tuning in, it's been a great event so far. Collaboration between Mac the Knife Global, MTK Global, and Coliseum Domination Boxing. Bit of a grudge match we have here today. Lolenga Mock and Veron have faced off before, with Mock unfortunately facing defeat by unanimous decision. So today Mock will be out to gain revenge and also to win the belt.
He will for sure. He is really on for this fight. It was it was a really bad experience for him last time. In Struer, where I was there, Evans was there as well, and yeah, he had a really bad intro for the fight, and the thing about coming in the ring and all that, it was on and off, and it was postponed for some minutes and all that. So he's really ready for revenge today.
World champion title, 47-year-old from Denmark, weighing at 74.5 kilograms yesterday. Ladies and gentlemen, Lolenga Mock!
Lolenga Mock coming to the ring now, hometown hero. This guy has had an incredible journey in boxing, which unfortunately we won't be able to go into too much detail about tonight, but he has got the support and the love from the local people of Denmark. He's really campaigning for this middleweight championship belt. So let's see how he can perform tonight. Just to confirm here, this is a super middleweight bout. I know the announcer said super welterweight, but yeah, this is a super middleweight bout.
It is.
This is Lolenga Mock's 60th fight. Please, a standing ovation for the fight.
60th fight for Lolenga Mock.
Yeah.
Impressive, to say the least.
It is. In the age of 47, he's been having so many great fights with great big boxers during his career.
Coming out with his longtime trainer here, Ivo de Lima of Champs Camp Aarhus, along with his nephew, who, if you all remember, won by first round knockout earlier on tonight. Mock coming out to his very, very unique music and style with the outfit. Always amazing to see from Mock. And yeah, it's just a pleasure to be commentating for such a consummate professional here tonight. Veron looking ready to go. Charged up. Let's see. Looks like it's going to be some great boxing. And as this is for a championship belt, we will now move on to the customary national anthems.
All right, once again, we're about to witness the 12-round boxing bout for the International Boxing Association Super Middleweight World Champion title. Now, the ring referee over here is Klaus Hagemann. Please round of applause. On the judges, we have Per Hansen, Ashley Hook, and Freddie Raff. And the supervisor of this match will be Yannick Schilling. All right, Mr. Boys, please. Yeah. Lolenga Mock, ladies and gentlemen! Mateo Damian Veron! Please make some noise for both of the fighters, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, this fight will be underway shortly. Both fighters in the ring now. National anthems and presentation of the belt out of the way. So now all that's left is to fight.
And Mock is looking really determined.
Yeah. I've never really seen him look so determined. I think he's prepared well for this fight. Great camp. He looks in great shape as usual. So let's see if he can edge over Veron this time.
Yes, exactly. The balance now is to. The important thing is now is to balance that tension and that determination, so it will last for the whole fight, mm-hmm. not being too stiff too. Wanting it too much, and he's a truly experienced guy, so he knows the game. We're on.
Okay, we're underway. Crowd here screaming Mock's name as it says it's known. He's a local hero. Got him in the corner early. Both fighters just feeling each other out early on. Mock switching his stance for a moment there.
Yeah, he's actually looking he's moving well, he's looking quite relaxed. Compared to this is the first round and he is so ready.
Veron already looks like he's taken some damage under that left eye there, so let's see if Mock can exploit that and try and capitalize on it.
Yeah, he will for sure go for every weak point that he can see on Veron.
Uppercut attempt there from Veron. Nice defense by Mock.
Yeah.
Big right hand there by Mock.
Yeah.
Veron nicely missing. Moving out of the way.
So he started out quite offensive, and we're down to a more looking each other, finding the distance. But of course, ready for fight anytime.
Jab there from Mock. Veron keeping the distance. Oh, okay. The fighters are falling out the ring on top of each other. Let's check everyone's okay. Mock looking really determined here. Okay. Slightly tense first round.
It was. Also, just the feeling, you can see the both of them, they just wanted to feel comfortable in the ring there, and but they know it's for real, and they know that they can't miss out on the appearance there, on the mental appearance there.
Yeah. Veron showing some good movement there early on in the round. Neither fighter really landing any clean shots.
No, I think Mock started out very well, pushing in and hitting him, but then it's the last part of the round. It was nice and easy. They were going, looking at each other, trying to find the distance and all that. So but you can see the fire in his eyes.
Mock's ready to go.
He is ready to go without any breaks, I think.
Nice job there by Mock.
Starting out again.
Very, very
explosive.
Rough.
Veron is holding his left hand there.
Looks like a real grudge match between these two. Shot there by Veron. A lot of holding by Veron there. Mock trying to break free. Pushing him into the corner. Quite scrappy at the moment. Both fighters looking quite agitated.
Yeah.
Got Mock in a headlock there. It's...
Mock is such a strong boxer. He has so much endurance. He can go like this for hours and hours. But it's a difficult fight for the judges to score if they are in too much clinch all the time and wrestling like this. So he can box everywhere, Mock, and with all distance. But he needs to go out and land some clean shots for the judges to be able to score it, actually.
Nice job by Mock there, nice jab. To the body, pushing Veron back.
Yeah, exactly. So
putting
now
off the ring. Oh, nice left hook there by Veron.
Yeah, and the uppercut. And
it's not looking good here.
He got Mock there with him.
Mock needs to hold tough here. Good shot there by Mock. Real slugfest early on here, this.
He is really catching, he's really throwing his punches, and they are really dangerous when they come like this. Ooh, and an
uppercut there by
again.
Veron. That was a shot to the...
And twice in the back head, and that's
back
not...
of the head there by Veron.
Yeah.
Uppercut there by Veron again.
I think Veron is hit on the left eye again now.
Both fighters looking really, really frustrated right now. almost like they're fighting. They're not even trying to box really at this moment in time.
No. This round really just developed into a slack fight.
Yeah.
And Veron opened up for all his. We have some slows here for
nice
all his.
Nice body shot there. Yeah. There we go. That's the combination. Veron landing some nice shots there.
Yes. Mock has to go back to the discipline boxing, using his long arms and his power and pushing him on the legs. Not letting him in like that.
Okay, third round. Veron liking that uppercut, keeps going to it. As Mock comes forward. Veron giving Mock a look there as if to say, come on. Again, holding.
And he's really open when he throws these uppercuts and the hooks, Veron.
Mock cutting off the ring nicely. Big right by Mock there, misses. Veron throwing this nice 1-2 to the body.
Yeah. Landing quite well.
The uppercut again from Veron.
He's taking too many punches now, Mock. Coming forward, that's good, but he cannot take a lot going in there.
Nice jab there by Mock. Crowd really getting behind Mock here, as you can hear in Aarhus.
Now stay in the distance there and boxing. Coming in with an uppercut again, Veron.
Nice shot there by Veron with the right hand. Nice left by Mock there. Oof, Veron again with that uppercut.
Yeah. He's landed some dangerous uppercuts here, Veron.
Yeah, Mock taking quite a lot of shots there, but...
In this round, yes. A little too much, I think.
See if he can settle down now, moving into the later rounds, find his composure. Veron's throwing a lot of shots, you know, moving well. Let's see if he can keep up this pace as the rounds progress. You know, a lot of action early on.
Yeah. The power of Mug is for sure that he has the endurance, he can go, but he can't take that many punches that he's done in this last round.
with the head there. Body shot by Mock.
And he holds.
Veron again with that nice body shot.
Yeah. Should keep it up now, Mock.
Mock looking like he's gaining some momentum here.
Yeah.
Veron saying no. No momentum. Yeah. Great fight so far. Veron missing both shots there. Now Mock finding the jab.
That's it.
Nice.
I'm
Mock finding
away.
The jab. Doing a good job. Veron looks nice and calm. Moving the head. Again, he says no.
Shaking the head. But again. You know, often it's also a sign of that you're not really feeling that well. Or you've just
uppercut
been hit a little
there.
Bit.
Oi.
So keep up that rhythm, Mock.
Oh, and big right hand there by Veron.
Yeah.
Mock handled it, though. Again, he's got to stop taking these shots. Double jab by Veron. It's a real war, this fight, already, early
it
on.
It is, early on, yeah. We're only in the fourth round.
Oh, Mock throwing a punch there. Referee giving him a warning to Veron.
He's a clever fighter, Veron. In all ways.
Yeah, slippery.
Yeah, and
yeah.
Also with the...
Oh, good combination there by Veron.
Also with the bad habits, you know, holding on the right times and all that. It's all the part of the game, so.
Good right hand, good left eye. He's hurting now. He's hurting Veron there.
Yeah, yeah, and he's holding now.
5 seconds left in the round. Let's see if we can get a slow-mo now where Mock gets him with this, I think it was a left hook. See this.
Too much wrestling there, but...
Yeah, a lot of pushing, a lot of fighting against the ropes. Nice jab there by Mock. Mock really needs to get behind this jab.
And follow up.
I think this might be it here where we saw... Nice shot from Mock. Yeah, there we go.
Yeah,
that was a great
hook.
Shot by Mock. The crowd shouting, come on, Mock. Come on, Mock.
And this fight has already went both ways, actually.
Yeah. Both fighters extremely experienced, had a lot of rounds. So let's see, be interesting as this fight progresses to see how their experience comes into play. No clean hits there.
Left hand is hanging by his hip. He's waiting to throw that uppercut again.
Yeah, he's waiting to throw the uppercut,
When Mock is bending and coming forward, and that's his style, you know, so...
Nice shot there by Mock, again.
good job. Good job keeping the pace in there. But then Veron comes back just right after.
Oh, big left hook by Veron there.
And just after Veron is hit, he comes back not only with punches, but also with the heavy punches.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's really...
But Mock seems very resilient, able to take some punches and continue.
Protecting himself a little bit better now, Mock, so...
Nice, there we go. Nice left hook by Mock there.
Running a bit too... Running forward a bit.
Referee struggling to separate the two. Okay, Mock looking a bit more relaxed now. Okay.
And he's aware of the uppercut now, Mock, because his right hand is... He has blocked it a couple of times.
Veron still looking light on his feet. Nice.
Good one.
Good shot there by Mock. Mock. Veron smiling.
Oi.
Oh.
Okay.
Slip there by Mock.
Have to.
Nice right hand by Mock there. That's the end of the fifth.
I think Mock has retained a bit of the control here.
And look at the slow-mos here. Nice jab there by Mock. Good body shot. Mock's starting to find his rhythm now.
Yes.
Settled down. Very agitated the first couple rounds, I would say.
And went into a storm in the second round where all these... Veron really got into the fight with some heavy shots.
So when a fight's scrappy like this, you know, the fighters are agitated, they want to hurt each other, they want to fight. What's the game plan? What's going through your head what should you be looking to do here?
All the time, to keeping your own thing working, your own boxing working. Of course, reading the opponent, but all the time getting back to your own boxing, controlling the fight, getting
your own tempo.
Yeah. Turning the fight into being your own fight, controlling it, getting your boxing to your own boxing to work. All the time. Punish the opponent every time he tries to get into the fight.
Nice combo there by Mock, pushing him back.
When it's a close fight like this, you don't really have an idea about how close it is. He's got a hit now, he's slipped. You're just taking every round for every round and just
as
boxing
it comes,
as it comes. And you don't think about how far and all that. You're just in the zone.
Mock pushing Veron back into the corner now. Veron holding. The uppercut there again by Veron. Mock doesn't seem too fazed by it though.
No, he is so resilient and he can take a lot, but he shouldn't do it because Veron is a dangerous boxer. But he's doing well now, Mock, and he's going a bit backwards, trying to just pushing it forward all the time. That's too dangerous.
There we go, he's got him in the corner now, Mock. Uppercut, but a nice jab by Veron again, followed by the uppercut. Mock cutting him down, cutting off the ring nicely. But Veron seems comfortable moving backwards.
Yeah. Mentally, it's actually a bit difficult because you can't really read him. You can't really see where he is. It's actually the round holding here, but the judge can't see it. That's the experience.
Crowd really getting behind Mock here.
And Mock has to get a little back on track now because it gets a little bit too wild. Veron is landing too many punches, I think.
It's 10 seconds of round six.
Up a card again.
Look at some of the slow-mos here. It's a nice combination by Mock there. Two clean hits. Nice uppercut by Mock there, you can see. But Veron followed up with a good jab. This is really hard to call at this stage. Quite a messy fight.
It is. It is quite messy, but it's rolling to each side every time, all the time. So yeah, when they're wrestling too much, it becomes too messy. But I think it's good boxing, and you don't know what will happen.
Okay, now the start of round seven. Okay, we've been joined now by Evans Ashira, a long time friend and sparring partner of Mock and former world champion, to take on some commentary for the second half of this fight. So Evans, what are your thoughts on the fight so far?
The fight from the beginning, both guys were tense, and they were tense. They were like too stiff, pushing around, muscling, and it was like not clean fight.
Low blow there, potentially.
Yeah. But then after round number four, they started opening up. Now it looks like they stable down a little bit, finding better targets now. And actually, as it looks on paper, it's much harder fight than anybody can see. Look at it on the paper.
It's nice very shot tough there by Veron. Mock retaliates. Veron says no. They deduct a point from Veron there?
They deduct a point. It's holding his...
From Veron?
From Veron, still pushing a little bit. But the fight is settling down now. I think it was a little bit too messy, the first almost four.
Nice head movement by Mock there.
Mock is using his defense better now, trying to walk behind the jab, trying to be calm.
Nice combinations there by Veron.
Veron looks faster. Taking off, landing cleaner shots.
Mock keeping on the pressure.
All the time. Mock keeping on pressure, pushing him back all the time. That's exactly what Mock need to do. Need to stay close to him, push him around, punch all the time.
Nice uppercut by Mock there.
Nice uppercut. That's the way Mock need to fight. There's no way you can fight a younger guy by giving him a lot of time. Put him under pressure again.
Mock really pushing forward, trying to smother Veron.
Yeah. Now landing some nice shots to me with the jab, especially working better the jab. Veron landing mid shots as well.
That's it. fourth round, hey, ladies and gentlemen.
You can see everybody's swinging hard. Everybody's trying to smother each other.
Nice body shot and a hook there by Veron. Okay, start of round eight. Been a tremendous war so far.
Very, very
hard to call at this stage.
It's very hard fight, actually. Both fighters are giving all their heart. Mock actually just need to keep that jab, touch him, then he can use overhand right, it should work. But every time you throw overhand right without having him feel the distance, then it's not good for him.
Oh, that's a nice shot by Veron there. Mock needs to be careful, but nice comeback. Oh, great comeback by Mock there.
Great contest. It's a quite back and forth fight. Mock's jab lands neat when he lands. Good job.
Nice job by Mock there. Again, that jab really seems to be working for Mock.
Definitely. Better on that stroke by Veron as well. Mock needs to keep pushing him. Keep pushing him. Backing, walking back. Walking back.
Again, that body shot, uppercut combination appears to be working quite well for Veron. But Mock's in tremendous physical condition.
Exactly. Work hard for this fight.
Shouldn't be taking too many of those. Mock. Nice two left hands there by Veron. Veron landing quite a few clean punches now.
Mock need to kill that rhythm. Needs to stay close. All of them. Push him back.
Push there for Mock, last 10 seconds of the round.
What do you say about this fight so far?
I think for me it's been a war from the beginning. Both of these fighters stepped in. They both seemed rather agitated, like they really want to get at each other. You know, they've settled down now somewhat, Mock finding some success behind the jab, but I think he's got to be careful of that left hook of Veron. He's landing that a little bit too much for my liking. But, you know, as a professional boxer yourself, what should Mock be doing there to try and get away from that left hook? Is it something as simple as keeping his hands up, or, I mean...
Well, I think it's not simple, but you need to let the hands go and need to push this guy. You need to mess him up. You need to make a fight rough.
Yeah.
You need to rough him up. He can't box. This guy's a better boxer than him. He's stronger than the guy, so you need to use that kind of strength. Push,
right.
Walk him back, keep throwing punches, get all those jabs in, and that's what's gonna bring the bacon home, because this is, if you keep it like this, it's too easy for Veron.
Right.
He's tapping out, he gas up, he go in, throw big punch, and go out, walk around like he's doing, get the oxygen back, and get in and do some damage. He need to stay on his chest, like he did round number five,
yeah.
Number four.
Yeah.
Stay on his chest and push him, hit him on the guard, hit him everywhere. That's a good job right there. This jab working good. You need to follow up. You can't throw one punch at a time. It's too easy for them.
Good combination again there by Veron.
See what I mean? He go out, get some more air, come out, throw punches. Mock need to land those shots like that and follow up. One more. Keep going.
Now smothering Veron. Now Veron trying to counter punch off Mock's jab. Again, two body shots there. Nice left hand by Mock. Big right hand there.
Mock needs to use a little more jab. He's landing a good job, but in sports, they need to follow up.
Big push there by Veron, being warned by the referee.
Oh.
Big right there by Veron, another one. Nice combinations now, Mock still pushing forward.
You need to push forward and stay forward.
Thoughts on that round, Evans?
The time of that round it was a little bit tough to decide, but I think Veron was mixed up by landing some clean shots in the end. Mock landed good jabs in the beginning, but he didn't follow up. You need to follow up to cut those breaks. You need to cut those blocks. Now you go round number 10. You need to give it everything you got. Because the fight goes back and forth. And the guy having won the last one, he don't want fight to go like that.
Yeah.
When I beat him convincingly, if possible, stop the fight.
Veron looking quite comfortable there. Doesn't seem too tired.
Mock need to take him off the comfort zone. Need to push him, need to bully him, need to punch everything he put forward. That's the only way. Because Veron seems to have good boxing skills and he's just taking breaks and coming when he wants to.
Again, two nice jabs there by Mock. Three.
Yeah, nice jabs.
Veron acknowledging it.
Need to follow.
Yeah.
Need to keep the stick moving. Especially to the body.
Again. Nice shot there by Veron. Veron throwing Mock to the floor there. One point deducted again. So for the viewers at home, Evans, what happened there? Why is a point deducted there? Is it because he used a part of the body he wasn't allowed to?
Or? He used his shoulder to push him down. So that's and it was a little bit too violent. So if he used it in a smart way, he should get away with it.
But it was too obvious there.
Too obvious, everybody can see it. And that's what cost him his point.
Now again on the ropes, fighting close, Mock.
Yeah. That's the way you should fight.
Mock seems to like that close fight with Veron.
The close fight is going to give him better result.
Trying to smother him.
Yeah, exactly. Smothering and landing his own shots. Staying too far is not good.
Big uppercut there. Veron throwing some big punches now. Mock needs to be careful. Eating a lot of shots
Mock
here
now. Need to hold him.
Nice shot there by Mock.
That's a nice hook.
Again by Mock. Good shot.
Mock is much stronger than Veron. So when he lands his shots, he really tell him.
Nice uppercut again by Mock.
It's a tough fight.
Very scrappy fight. Very scrappy fight. Yeah.
Wow. Ladies and gentlemen. We are on to the last two rounds.
Let's see if we can see that shoulder push. See that?
Yeah.
That was very obvious. Very obvious. Shots there. That in the corner, you see like Mock's trying to swing in shot. Why you should choose the 6 inches punches when you're too close.
Okay. Round 11.
It's a hell of a fight.
Both fighters showing no signs of. Okay, looks like Mock's wrapping on his glove has come undone there.
Time was fast, we need to refit the glove.
Come, no, accept the tape, you are one. Johnny.
This fight been tough.
Come on, Johnny, tape, heal, I one.
Quite hard. Yeah. The problem is a little scrap in the middle of the fight and they're using a lot of energy. Good job for Mark. I need those jabs like that this time.
Again, eating quite a few shots there. Mock, but Veron doesn't appear to have power to put him away.
He don't have power enough to really hurt Mock. Landing clean needs to have nothing happened.
Yeah, they're not really hurting him, even though they're landing clean.
Yeah, they're not. But Mock need to be careful anyway. Suddenly one comes in that hurts him.
Good uppercut by Mock
good
there.
Uppercut.
Wow, ferocious combo by Veron there. You can hear him letting that energy out.
Yeah.
Nice parry there by Mock.
Yeah.
Uppercut again. Nice left hand by Mock twice. Uppercut again.
He need to box like that. I think that's better for him. Keep running, bro. Keep pushing him back. Put weight on him. Just keep throwing shots, punches, guards, everything he does.
Nice shot by Mock there. Nice uppercut.
She get out of the corner, turn him around.
Veron missing there. Big shot, so Mock needs to be careful.
Need to be careful. If a guy doesn't hurt you, sudden lip shot case you didn't see it. Oi.
Crowd getting behind Mock now.
Yeah. It's the way you need to box. Just push him, bully him.
Body shot there by Mock, you can see on the replay. Neither fighter seems to be hurting the other one.
Exactly, it seems the punches last, it seems like all of them can take good shots. All of them can take good shots. Tough 12 rounds of fight. Pushing, muscling around, growling, scrapping. Gonna be a hell of a night. They're gonna sleep really hard.
Last round now.
Last round, yeah.
Let's see whether they leave it all out there or whether they take it a little bit similar to how they have been doing all night. I think they're gonna leave it all out there.
Yeah, I think so. I think so, because
Veron swinging big early. Big uppercut there by Veron.
Oh, nice.
That's been a great shot for him tonight.
It's been, yeah, it's been crazy. Even the uppercut been landing many times, but seems not to have so much power because he haven't done any damage yet.
No.
Not even bleeding.
Nice left hook there by Veron.
This is a little difficult. It's been a little difficult to pull those five bosses. It's give and take. Good swings here, man. Good drop right without Mock.
Mock leaning on Veron now.
Exactly.
Trying to wear him out.
Try to wear him down. Hold him back. Man, everybody's leaving everything they got there.
Yeah, 1 minute left in the round. These guys are going for hell. Referee gonna break him up here now. Too much holding. 30 seconds left in the round. Veron throwing some big shots. Mock coming back for some shots of his own. Mock's glove is undone again. Will the ref spot that?
Yeah.
I think he's gonna let it go. 10 seconds left.
10 seconds.
Wow. What a fight. What a fight. Wow.
What a fight. What a fight.
Well,
look at that finishing there.
Tremendous night of boxing for sure.
Tremendous night. There's been a lot of good fights tonight. Massive good fight.
Tough to call that fight, Evans.
Very tough to call. I'm really hoping Mock wins this fight because he needs more than anything. He's closing his spot, and he did everything he could. Even it's hard to call their own shots because they landed a lot of them, but they didn't do damage. So the legitimacy of shot was a little bit difficult. Maybe just Mock can take fights.
Small cut under his eye there, Veron.
And Mock also ran the shot and didn't happen nothing to Veron. So I don't know this guy's has been. It's a very tough night.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we're now about to find out who is the winner of the main event, Mock versus Veron, for the vacant IBA Super Middleweight World Championship. Very tough fight to call.
Very, very tough fight. It's a tough fight to call.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the world champion title in super middleweight category of the International Boxing Association is, there was a split decision, so we're gonna go to the scorecard first. Judge Rene Larson, 112-114. Judge Per Hansen, 114-112. judge Andre Hook, 114 and 112. And by split decision, the winner of the International Boxing Association Super Middleweight World Championship title is Lolenga Mock!
So, ladies and gentlemen, your new IBA Super Middleweight World Champion, Lolenga, the Lumumba Boy Mock. Brought to you live from Aarhus, Denmark.
Vibu Holland.
Vibu Holland. An event put on by MTK Global in association with Domination Boxing Policy in Denmark. We're now going to go off the air, and we're going to be shortly following up with a press conference. We'd like to say thank you to all the boxers tonight. Tremendous show here in Aarhus with
nice
some...
Great evening.
Some world-class boxing, some great commentary. I've been joined by two pros here who've helped me out all night, so I'd like to say thank you to you two also.
Appreciate your time.
And yeah, we'll be speaking to you soon via the press conference.
Some of the people to leave the ring. The ring can't hold so many people. Lolenga! People on the ring, please step down from the ring, please.